Oh my God, look at that. I got a mite running around. Probably a terrible sign. Moment of truth. All sorts of mites in there.
So this end hive got tipped over a couple of weeks ago. A link to that video is above.
You can see this tear, it is at a terrible angle here. So I guess I'm looking for eggs or queen cells, because if the queen got killed in that mess when this tipped over, then we should be seeing queen cells by now. Hopefully I'm seeing eggs and we're all good. The other thing I forgot, the other thing I want to do today is check for mites. I'll probably only check a couple of these. You know, I'm in the middle of a treatment right now, so. That queen is doing. I've heard people say that they've found their queen, you know, hanging out right at the top on the queen excluder. So it is a good idea to check that. I certainly don't always do that. Don't remember to do it always. There's a ton of brood here. I mean, this is great. There we go. Capped brood, but you can see some very, very young larvae in there too. So that should be good enough for me. Yeah, that's all very young. That's all very young in there. So now I'll take my sample from here, taking my time. Make sure that the queen is not here. She made it through that ordeal a week ago, 10 days ago. So I would hate to alcohol wash her now. Moment of truth. All sorts of mites in there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, I typically have a tough time getting a good shot of this. There's always some debris in there too, so you gotta kind of sort out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I still count 7. All right, I'm gonna dig into this hive. Check the super, test for mites. Not much going on up top there. Nice, yeah, okay. So I've got, this is all brood. It's really nice, looks great. I mean, it looks like the queen's definitely doing her job. She's finding all the open spaces that she can. And she's laying them up. So that's all emerged and backfilled. You can see some play cups on the bottom. Nothing in them. Oh my God. Look at that. I got a mite running around. See, it's crawling across the open brood there. It's looking for a spot. That's amazing, I've never seen that before. Probably a terrible sign. Still hasn't gone in yet. Walking along the edge. All right, oh, my battery died there, but That was really interesting to see that mite crawling around. I've only seen them on drone comb that I've broken off a frame. I've never seen one walking around, but that's what, you know, I mean, that's what they do. I just happened to catch that one. That's what they do. They climb into those open cells. It gives me a bad feeling when I see something that small, like when I'm able to see it, like the number's gonna be super high. I haven't looked at this yet, but you know, that one was treated too with the formic acid from the Mite Away Quick Strips 10 days ago. So all the mite drop that was gonna happen from that stuff would have already happened. Here we go, moment of truth. It always looks terrible when you do this. You look up and you see a bunch of mites. It always feels like, oh my God, I'm infested. But then when I take a pause and realize, well, it's 300 bees. We're looking for 3% or less. I mean, you want it to be zero, but you're looking for 3% or less. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yep, I keep getting 10. So that would be just over 3%, right? If this was 300 bees. I actually dump this out and just count, you know, if I'm 400 bees, then my percentage is considerably different. It's a decent sample. I think last year when I was testing a little bit light, and I really wanted to get a good solid sample here. I mean, you see my sample size there. I'll let you know. Well, it's kind of morbid, but I counted them. I put them into piles of 10. I have 28 piles, so 280, and then left over 8, so 288. So, I mean, the count is correct. It was only 12 off as far as trying to get a sample of 300 bees. Still kind of works. Yeah, there she goes. Tell you what, I bought this smoker fuel. It's like leftover from the cotton process, and that's what I'm using. It stays lit for a long time. Seems to work pretty good. Just a smattering, just a little bit of honey in here. That's it. I'm gonna leave them alone. In here, check this guy real quick. Sometimes on, like, right now in real life, I can't see the smoke very much, so I see a little wisp, and then when I see it on the camera, it's like, oh, I was really kind of going overboard there. But well, for whatever reason, these guys, that's quite a bit. They only had two, they only have drawn comb here on two of these frames, three of these frames. The rest is foundation. So since I'm not swapping out full supers, I will go get the supers and put in some drawn comb, because if they're gonna pack away honey, I'll give them the equipment to do it. There you go, see how they like that. I think this was a brand new super, like brand new frames, everything. You can see that they're working on it pretty good. You can see all the work they've done up top, but I will do the same thing here. Swap out whatever frames I can. There you can see some work, some good work on there. Brand new frame that they were just starting to draw out. All right, well, that's all I'm gonna do for the rest of today. So, decent day, not a lot of extra honey. Treatments are working. Varroa is in check, but not completely down, so I'll have to keep that in mind. Thanks for watching. Steve Loomis with Father Daughter Honey.